All right, so let's talk about how to export high quality images for Instagram. Intro. Okay, so I upload a lot of stuff to Instagram, like photos, videos, behind the scenes, photo ideas, and all kind of stuff like that. And a few people ask me how to export photos so you can get the best quality when you upload them to Instagram. So that's why I've collected a few tips and tricks that you can use to get the best quality. So let's get started. And the first tip is, of course, all about the image itself. What I mean is that if you just take random pictures without caring about your camera settings, you limit your images before you even start to upload your photos. So it's extremely important to keep that in your mind when you take photos, and especially if you want to edit your pictures, you should use RAW files. And RAW files basically makes it possible to edit pictures because they save a lot of information that can be used to do all kind of stuff in your editing software. So yeah, if you would use JPEG files instead to edit your pictures, you will run into problems, and in most cases, if you start to edit these files, you will lose a lot of quality. And yes, I will be a video about that on my channel really soon, and I will show you the differences between JPEG editing and RAW file editing, because this is an extremely important step before you start to upload your images. But yeah, basically, if you want to edit your pictures, don't use JPEG files. The second tip we need to talk about for the preparation is all about cleaning your lens before you shoot. And yeah, a lot of people don't really think about that before you start to take pictures, but if your lens isn't clean, it can actually affect the image quality as well. So avoid fingerprints, dust, and all kind of stuff like that by simply cleaning your lens from time to time. But now let's talk about how to actually prepare your images for Instagram. So let's talk about the Instagram recommendations. And yeah, these are basically guidelines that you should follow to get the best results. Because if you don't follow these guidelines, the Instagram compression tool needs to do it for you. And in this case, it's most likely that your picture will lose a lot of quality. And basically, Instagram recommends a 4:5 picture ratio. You simply can crop your images in your editing software or app. In Lightroom, you can do it right here. Simply select this tool, and next you can use the 4:5 option. And right after that, you can select the area that you want to use. So definitely do that before you start to upload your images so Instagram doesn't have to do that for you. Another really important tip that I want to give you is all about the editing process, and here especially the size and sharpness. I highly recommend to give your photos a little sharpness boost to let your key elements stand out. And that is extremely important because everyone sees your image on a small screen, and that makes it harder to maintain all the details. So before you export your images, always double check your photo, make the image smaller on your screen to see if everything is fine. So now you're done with the editing. So let's talk about the export. And here I always use JPEG to compress my final edit all the way down. But this is really important here. I always use the highest export quality because Instagram will compress your image again, so I don't want to lower the quality right in advance. Another setting that I use is a Pro Photo RGB right here. In my opinion, the image quality is in this case way better, but some people say use sRGB because Instagram can handle that better. So what I recommend is to export an image in both file formats and then upload it to Instagram to see which one you like the most. And next we need to talk about another really important step, and this is the picture size. So yeah, the picture size is a really important step if you want to upload to Instagram. Instagram recommends to use a short edge with 1080 pixels for portraits, and for landscapes a long edge with 1080 pixels too. Otherwise, again, Instagram will do it for you, and that's something you definitely want to avoid. So yeah, in the end, it's really important to stick to the Instagram instructions. Of course, it may require some more work, but I think it's worth it, and if you do it, you shouldn't see any unexpected changes. But there's another really important aspect we need to talk about, and this is how you send the picture to your phone. So yeah, if you send the photo via email or messenger to your phone, your photo gets compressed again, and this leads to a lower quality. So instead, use a cloud system, AirDrop, or simply connect your phone to your computer and import the files that you want to use to avoid this additional compression. And yeah, right after that, you can simply upload your images to Instagram. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new here, don't forget to smash that subscribe button to stay updated for our upcoming videos, and I'll see you in the next video.